Yeah, so it's Gaz here from Moth Creatura with another quick video. Just finished the gym. This is sweating mess. As most of you know, I'm trying to rest this phone. As most of you know, I do my gym every morning. I'm going to do my skipping and my crunches. You've got to get into this routine. It's what your body needs. Your body's crying out for this. It needs spontaneity, but some things it needs routine that you can build spontaneity on. If you've got a base level, and fitness is one of them things. It helps prevent injury, it helps your recovery, all this sort of stuff. I know all this good kit. I've known this kit for years, been in the military for 24 years. But I'm also human, so sometimes I'll be incredibly lazy and I'll sit on my arse and I'll do nothing. And then I'll pick up injuries or I'll struggle with things, but mentally I'll be there. Just my body can't keep up with what my mind's telling us to do. So that's why it's just easier to maintain your level of fitness. It's hard work, but it makes it easier for the days that you do need your fitness and you need to rely on it. So recently I've been posting videos of me skipping and sort of how I've been improving. And it's not to show off or anything, it's to try and share with you my own journey, you know, to try and hopefully inspire some people, you know. It's not, you know, no one's born with the ability to do stuff. Everything takes practice, you know. Athletes, they're not born with a pair of running spikes on their feet, you know, or a cycle or a swimming cap on or anything like this. You know, they learn. And the practice and the practice and the practice and the practice, and that's what makes them good. Their own determination, personal pride. And so the skipping, a few weeks ago I thought I'm going to increase the tempo by 10%. Listening to advice on the internet or from people like business people like Elon Musk, when they talk about putting in more hours in a day. So do your sort of 7-hour day, great. That's going to take you X amount of time to get to where you want to be. Increase that tempo to 10 hours a day and you're going to get there quicker than if you were just doing the 7 hours a day because you're putting in more work. Now, clearly there is a caveat with that because we all have a natural exhaustion point where we can't give enough, you know, we can't give any more. So we just burn out. So there's got to be a time where you've got to stop because you're just wasting energy then, not achieving. But with the gym, I thought I'm going to increase my tempo. So I was doing 30 minutes skipping. And I was doing 300 crunches with a now an 8 kilogram dumb, what do you call them, kettlebells. But the way that I broke it down was I do them in sets. So I do 3 minute skipping and then 30 crunches. And I did that 10 times. And I thought I'm going to increase it now because I'd got comfortable with what I was doing. I'm going to increase it by 10%. And what that meant to me was put an extra set of skipping on the end, an extra set of crunches. Now, I didn't do this on day one, week one. I did it after weeks and weeks and weeks of doing this nearly every day. So my body's got accustomed to it. I've got used to it. So I'm now trying to push that comfort zone a little bit more because I've got used to what I'm doing. I've been asked before why I wear a hat in the gym when it's bloody red hot. You know, we lose all the heat through our heads, you know, heat rises. So I try and keep a hat on, a woolly hat on. It helps keep me ear pod things in my ears, right? Also, it helps keep the heat inside of us, my core heat. Whether it's right or wrong, I don't know, but mentally it works for me. I think I'm working harder by doing that. I couldn't do that on day one. I'd probably end up having a freaking stroke. Overheating, cooking myself. But now I do it because I'm used to it. And it means that now when it's really hot weather, I'm better acclimatized than if I wasn't doing this because I'm used to working in heat. But then this week and today, I've been trying to learn double unders with the skipping. And you'll have seen people that are mad into CrossFit doing it. Never done CrossFit. I don't have anything against CrossFit. I've just never known anything about it. I've never had any friend circles of people that do it. So I've never like sort of tried it. Never had any clubs nearby where I am. And to be frank, I've probably been quite intimidated because they're all beasts, like pure monsters, aren't they? And I'm not. I'm a skinny geezer. And so I've probably shied away from any opportunity where it might have arose. But I did admire what they do. They push themselves. And sometimes you see them sitting there just doing nothing, but it's probably because they're trying to recoup before they can go and smash themselves again another 100%. So I've been trying to do double unders, and I always told myself I didn't need to. As long as I could skip with a good rhythm and a good pace, I didn't need to do double unders. Well, what do I want to do that for? Showboating. That's what I convinced myself. So I believed that. And then this past week, I've been trying to do double unders, slowly introducing them over the past few weeks, like just one double under and then normal skipping. And then trying two double unders, then normal skipping. And then this week I tried linking a few together, and I tell you what, it's been mad frustrating. It's been hard work. And every time it was going wrong, I was pissed off with myself and I was beating myself up about it. And the voice inside my head was like, I don't have fucking voices inside my head, but the voice inside my head, like the one that's supposed to encourage us, because it's me. It was like, fuck's sake, man, you fucking dickhead. Like, that's how I talk to myself. It's shocking. And it just occurred to us that maybe I'm not the only one like that. I think we probably all do that. I think we probably all are harshest critics. We beat ourselves up too much. You wouldn't speak to your fucking friends or your family like that. And if you do, you need to fucking go and check yourself. I'm not talking about in an argument. I'm talking about normal routine, normal day jogging. But trying to do double unders and then tripping up or hit myself in the head or doing anything like this. And I'm worried about what people in the gym think. Like, I look stupid. And that's ridiculous. Like, if I'm out driving and I see someone that's maybe a bit overweight running at the side of the street, I don't think they're a twat. I think, fucking good on you. Genuinely, that's what I think. So I'd never think bad about someone trying. I might have my reservations about someone sitting on their arse, whinging about the state of things, but not trying themselves, and then whinging about other people who are trying. I might have a sort of thought about that. Not one I'd share with yous. But someone that's trying, that's a fucking positive thing. So then I started thinking to myself, stop worrying about what these people in the gym think. You don't know what they think. They might think something good. They might think something bad. It doesn't fucking matter. It's their thoughts. It don't belong to you. You just crack on what you're doing. Let them crack on what they're doing. And then when I started thinking like that, then I stopped beating myself up as much. So when it was going wrong, I stopped beating myself up. And when I stopped beating myself up, thinking in my head, fucking hell, you dickhead. When I stopped being like that, things started becoming easier. I wasn't like this coiled spring. So no, have I got finesse? Nah, I'm just learning it. But as soon as I calmed down with myself when it didn't go right, and I just took a moment, had a breath, tried again. Took a moment, tried again, took a moment, tried again. And if it meant that I had to take a moment longer and just get it out my head, clear my head, rather than trying straight away, then I did that. And then I tried it again. And you know what it is? I was linking 5, 6, 7, 10, 15 double unders in a go. Again, no, I haven't got finesse. You know, I'm jumping around like some bloody loon. But the point is, I couldn't have got to doing 10, 15 in a row if I was still beating myself up. So I started cutting myself some slack. And the voice inside my head started supporting what I was trying to do, as it should, because I'm the only one in there that wants me to achieve this. No one else gives a shit. So as soon as I had my own back and I started being more supportive about what I wanted in life, specifically in the gym there, I started achieving. So it was just me sharing a message today about cut yourself some slack. So when things don't go to plan, you can think of the universe has got ideas for you. You haven't learned a lesson in life yet and it needs to teach you this lesson, and that's why it's going to keep doing it, you know. Think all that if that helps you. Great, I'm not knocking that sort of philosophy. Or you can just think more easily. You want to achieve this. It doesn't go to plan. Stop beating yourself up. Calm down. Take a breath and try again. And keep on trying until you get it. And when you get it, you know you've never took a shortcut. You know that next time you go and do it, just like riding a bike, you're going to do it. And gradually it'll improve. And then you can practice and practice and practice and get to start doing that new skill, like without thinking, just like you did your old skills. So there you go. That was my thought for the day. Have a nice day, everyone. Take care. Bye-bye.
no, no, no.